laughing out loud. It keeps going and going and going.
You know, we look at all the flaws and what he did. He don't take care of his kids. He not with his woman, you know. And why is he doing these things? But y'all show me that you gotta go back and look at what he been through. What was done to him when he had been in slavery. When he seen his woman took from him. When he seen his babies took from him. And he was told not to feel it. You can't put a man in that state and make him not feel that. You told him to be numb to that situation. So look what he do today. He's numb to that situation. His generations behind him are numb to that situation. They forgot. Because it was embedded into them. You cannot put a man in that situation and expect him to react any different. The only way he gonna react different is when he fall in love with Yah to recreate that whole process of thinking that's been put into him. He gotta destroy that. That's the only way. So when you see him and he's not taking care of him, yeah, don't get me wrong, he has a responsibility. But that's the reason why the black family power structure is all destroyed. Because the black man was attacked from the beginning through slavery. Somebody had a plan. Somebody wanted to capture these people. I said today and I'll say it again. If black men and women wanted to leave this nation will fight to keep them here. You tell me there's something ain't about that. You tell me that that ain't real. They will not let you leave here alive. That's why it's gonna take y'all. That's why it's gonna take y'all. Lord help us, man. We took that slave man mentality in our religion that was given to us, and we brought it into the church, and we give it back to other black people. And you think that you ever gonna get ahead doing that? You find the truth in the book. You find the truth in some scriptures, and you still teaching what you was taught from the slave man. Instead of teaching what you know, God just showed you. Now how you expect somebody like me to come and sit in there and listen to you? It's not happening. I gotta talk to y'all for myself. Study and show yourselves approved. This system isn't for you. This system isn't for you. You gonna have to dig down and start talking to y'all. If you wanna make it, you gotta be prepared to leave it all alone. You gotta be prepared to give it all up. Seek life. That's what it's all about at the end of the day. No matter how much riches you got, no matter what you say you got in power, no matter what it is, at the end of the day, you gotta be prepared to give it all up. And these men and women aren't prepared to give it all up. And that's the reason why. That's why these preachers ain't gonna preach the truth. You think they gonna preach you anything about tithing and stuff like that and tell you not to do it? What's been handed down to them, and they know they getting that receiving end of that money? What if they don't have to, got nothing coming in, and they gotta praise God and thank God for everything that they got? They gotta have faith now. That's why I say the church is weak. That's why I say the church is weak. Cause they don't see no faith no more. They only go after that what they see. I refuse to be paid and be a slave. You still in the prison. How you think you gonna make it out of there? You still in the prison when you look at yourself in the mirror.